Students, in this video, so we'll discuss about the next bit of the topic, that is transport of gases. So of this chapter, breathing and exchange of gases. So transport of gases, how it takes place in our body. So gases means here O2 and CO2. So how these are moving, are transported from one place to another place. So from where it is supplied and where it should be eliminated. So that means oxygen is supplied and carbon dioxide is eliminated. So how exactly it takes place? So we shall discuss now this concept, the gas transport. So that means this respiratory gas, right? Respiratory gases transport respiratory gases transport is in of two ways. So there is a two ways are there. So that means two types in different ways, let us we discuss. So actually the respiratory gases are of two type of transport is there, and so the oxygen transport, that types are oxygen transport and CO2 transport, right? That is oxygen transport and CO2 transport, right? So this oxygen transport is done in two ways. It is done in two ways, and the CO2 transport in three ways. So let us we discuss the details about the oxygen transport in two ways. Yes, these are the ways, right? So we'll choose first the transport of oxygen, that is oxygen transport. The first way that we choose oxygen transport, the first way is, right? So actually the hemoglobin is required for the transportation of this oxygen, because oxygen when combines with the hemoglobin, it's become oxyhemoglobin and it will be transported. And even the gases, these respiratory gases also dissolved in the liquid state of blood, that is plasma, right? So usually about 97% as oxyhemoglobin, 97% of O2 is combined with the oxygen, and which is transported as in the form of oxyhemoglobin, right? Oxygen plus HbO2, right? So that is oxyhemoglobin, right? So here the 97% of oxygen, this is the first way what I am discussing. Here two ways are there. So about 97% of oxygen is transported as oxyhemoglobin, means in combined state. So that is with the Hb plus oxygen. So that is this oxygen is combined with the Hb and it forms that oxyhemoglobin, right? So this, in this form it will be transported, right? So how exactly, see, the oxygen binds to hemoglobin, that hemoglobin, as we know that in the RBC, right? So which is present in the red colored iron containing pigment present in RBC as we know, right? And it to form a oxyhemoglobin. This is called the oxygenation. That means mixing of this oxygen with Hb in the blood, that is in the RBC, is called oxygenation. What you call? Oxygenation. That process is called oxygenation, right? So Hb has four heme units. The Hb means hemoglobin has four units called heme units that contain 4S heme units. Heme units, right? So binding of oxygen depends upon the PO2 and PCO2, PCO2 and H plus ions concentration, or H plus means here almost pH, that depends on the pH concentration. Concentration and even temperature, and temperature, right? So means the oxygenation is depends on the PO2. So that means the already the oxygen, how much percent of oxygen is dissolved in it, means in the blood, and PCO2 carbon dioxide percentage, and H plus ions means pH of the blood, and even temperature of the body. So all these are the important factors which affects on this process, that is called the formation of oxyhemoglobin, right? So in this form, so in RBC there is a Hb, so when oxygen is enters here, so it will become oxyhemoglobin. So this oxyhemoglobin formation is known as the oxygenation, right? So this is actually depends on the PO2 and PCO2 H plus ions concentration, means pH concentration, and or even temperature, right? So the one more way we'll discuss later, that in alveoli, so usually, so how exactly the mechanism is takes place here, let us we see in alveoli. So you can consider this is the alveoli. So high PO2 will be there, that is high PO2 will be present, and low, so you can consider this is the high PO2 and low CO2, sorry, PCO2, yes, PO2, a lesser H plus ions concentration, and even H plus ion is also less, right? So next, the usually lower temperature exists, and temperature is also less. I'll take here temperature is also less, only oxygen level is more, and remaining temperature and PCO2 and H plus means pH is less. So what happens, so around the capillaries, around this what you called the alveoli, so this is what the alveoli. So here it is alveoli, the concentration of the O2 is more and remaining is less. These factors are favorable for the formation of oxyhemoglobin. So these factors, so which allows the S, so usually this is allowed to enter the S, oxygen enters the hemoglobin which is present in the RBC of bloodstream, right? So that helps to form the oxygenation, that is oxyhemoglobin, in the alveolar region. And next, so about 3%, here 97% is transported in this way, and remaining, yes, so that remaining 3% of oxygen is transported with dissolved state, that is carried in the dissolved, yes, which is dissolved state, So dissolved means in the through the plasma, dissolved in the plasma of blood plasma. So in the blood plasma it is dissolved and transported, right? But maximum is in presence of HB is very important to transport this one, so we should remember. And next we go for the transport of the second one is CO2 transport of CO2 or CO2 transport. How carbon dioxide is transported in the circulatory system or throughout the body. So it is in three ways. So this is in actually this is in dissolved state and with hemoglobin, two states it is dissolved. So but here in a three ways are there, three ways of CO2 transport. So let us we see first one, about 70% as bicarbonates. 70% first I'll choose maximum one. 70% of CO2 is transported as bicarbonates, right? So here it is transported by this way. So RBCs and plasma contains an enzyme, RBCs and plasma. So in the RBC and plasma contain the enzymes, that is carbonic anhydrase. That enzyme is called carbonic anhydrase. So this enzyme facilitate the following reactions, right? So means here the what happens, the another way of CO2 transport is with as carbonic acid. That is about 7% of CO2 as carbonic acid. So because as we know that carbon dioxide can dissolve in the liquids, especially in the water, right? So in the tissue, so about 7% of CO2 is dissolved in the plasma water. So the plasma of blood, so is considered as a rich 95% of water. So that's what this water when combined with this CO2 means it is dissolved, so that forms the carbonic acid. Yes, carbonic acid, right? So which forms the carbonic acid. So in this form it is carried to the lungs. So in the bloodstream as a carbonic acid, so it will be reached to the lungs, which will reach to lungs through capillaries, right? Through blood capillaries. So this way also transportation is done and which is eliminated there. And next the third way. So this is the first way, second way, third way, the transport of CO2 is the about it is considered 22-25% of CO2 is transported as carbamino hemoglobin is also involved in the this transportation of CO2, not only the oxygen. So here the about 20-25% of CO2 binds with Hb, CO2 which is binds with Hb and forms the carbamino hemoglobin. That means that is even the carboxy hemoglobin, we may also call it as carboxy hemoglobin, right? So here the In alveoli, CO2 dissociates from carbaminohemoglobin, and by that it is eliminated. So in this way, three ways are there. About 70% of CO2 as bicarbonates, which will be reached to the lungs, and where due to enzymes, so that carbon dioxide is eliminated from this bicarbonates and it is released out, right? So in this way, there is a transportation of O2 and CO2 is takes place. So it is the O2 transport. Here you can observe the transport of O2 in two ways, and carbon dioxide transport in three ways, which is with hemoglobin, so as carbaminohemoglobin, so which forms with in presence of Hb, right? So, and about 7% is with dissolved state, that means in which is combined with the which is actually combined with the plasma water and forms the carbonic acid, right? So in this way, and another 70% is as bicarbonates, right? So in this way, there is a three ways of CO2 transport we observed. And so about, so finally, so when you observe, so about 100 ml of the 100 ml of oxygenated blood can deliver 100 ml of oxygenated blood can deliver so about 5 ml of O2 and about 100 ml of CO2, means deoxygenated blood, so can deoxygenated blood is deoxygenated oxygenated blood, and deoxygenated blood can eliminate about 4 ml, about 4 ml of CO2. So this is what the transportation, right? So we may observe the transportation in this way. Yes, so we'll discuss the remaining in the next class. Thank you, students.